Hello everyone, so welcome to my channel once again. So today's topic is buds and its modification. So as you know that buds are condensed immature shoot, fine? So let's start with the definition. Buds are compact, underdeveloped shoot, fine? Or this is one definition. Other can be, we can call it as also condensed, immature or embryonic shoot, fine? So it is a part of shoot. So the fact about this, very important fact, is the largest bud is of cabbage and the scientific name of it is Brassica oleracea, fine? So this is a this cabbage itself is the largest bud. Now I will be telling you that the buds are of different types. There are different bases on which we can differentiate it. So number one type is on the basis of position. So on the shoot, on the stem, there are two types of bud you will see. If we will see here, this is the stem, you will find two type of buds. One at the apex, the apical part, there is a bud, and the other which is present at the sides of the stem. So on that basis we will classify them into two category. One is apical or terminal bud and other one is called as lateral bud. Fine. So apical bud, it is present at the apical part of stem. Okay, this one is the apical bud. Apart from this part, if on the stem, on the other sides or the part of the stem, if buds will develop, that will be called as lateral bud. Fine. Now lateral bud is having different types. Number one is axillary bud, then accessory bud, and the third type is extra axillary bud. One by one I will be telling you its position. Extra axillary bud. Okay, so here first, axillary bud. About it, it grows at axile of leaf. Fine? Axile means, axile is the angle between the upper surface of leaf and the stem. So this is the axile. Fine. So if any bud will develop in the axile, that will be called as axillary bud. So if any bud is developing here, that bud will be called as axillary bud. Okay. So it grows at axile of leaf. And example is, you will see in case of rose and sunflower. Next is accessory bud. Accessory bud grows at axile of single leaf or side of axillary bud. What is accessory? Fine. Accessory jo hota hai wo kuch extra hota hai. जो मेन लाइक इफ वी आर वेयरिंग इयररिंग्स एंड वी आर हैविंग इवन एवरीथिंग कार इज हैविंग एसेसरीज सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम द बेसिक पार्ट इफ वी आर एडिंग समथिंग एक्स्ट्रा दैट इज कॉल्ड एसेसरी सो इन केस ऑफ बड ऑल्सो इफ एनी बड ग्रोज हियर फाइन एट द साइड ऑफ द एक्सिलरी बड that will be called as accessory bud or at the axil of single leaf that is also called as axillary buds the last one that is extra axillary bud is a bud which develops at the base of leaf means it is not growing at the axil of leaf fine again I'm telling you what is axil It is angle between upper surface of leaf and stem. Fine. So, if opposite to it any bud is growing, that bud is known as extra axillary. So, I can write here as at the base of leaf opposite to axil okay you will see this kind of structure in case of solanum nigrum okay so this is the different types of buds on the basis of their position. So I told you on the basis of position, it can be of two type. One is apical, which can also be called as terminal bud, which will grow at the apex of the stem. And the other one is the lateral bud, which grows at the sides of the stem. Now, lateral buds can be divided into three categories. One is axillary, accessory, and extra axillary bud. So, axillary which grows at the axil, if at the axil of single leaf or beside the axillary bud, if bud comes or other bud comes, that will be called as accessory. And if opposite to the axil, if buds develop, that will be called as extra axillary. So, next criteria is on the basis of nature. So, if you will see here, you will find there are three categories. One is vegetative bud. Next is floral bud. From the name only you can guess. And other is mixed. So, in this case, in vegetative bud, this bud will give rise to vegetative part. Vegetative parts like root, stem, leaf. Okay. So, if any bud which gives rise to vegetative part, it will be called as vegetative bud. If the bud gives rise to floral part, means if it gives rise to flower, it will be called as floral bud. And the last category, if it gives rise to either vegetative part or floral part. Fine. In last case, it can give rise to vegetative also. It can give rise to floral bud also. Ye flower bhi bana sakta hai, ye vegetative parts bhi bana sakta hai. It depends the timing of that plant and season of the plant. Fine. So, these are the three buds, types of buds on the basis of nature. Category is on the basis of on parts they grow. On the parts they grow. Okay. So, if the bud grows on stem, it will be called as collin buds. Okay. If they grows on leaf, they will be called as foliage or epiphyllous bud. Example is bryophyllum. Fine. In case of bryophyllum, on leaf you will see the buds are growing, and later on that bud will develop into a complete plant. Fine. So if bud grows on leaf, it is called as foliage or epiphyllous bud. Third category is if the bud grows on root, that will be called as radical. Okay, radical bud. This you will see in case of curry leaf plant, जिसको हम मुराया भी बोल सकते हैं. Right, scientific name मुराया. In that case, or Delbergia. In both the cases, you will see, I have taught you that, है ना? That on root, you will see a bud which develops into a whole plant. Means there the root is helping in vegetative propagation. If the bud grows on the root, it is known as radical bud. So, these are the three criteria on basis of which we can classify the types of buds. Now, I will be teaching you the modification of buds. So, before that, you can please take the screenshot. So, next topic is modification of bud. Modification of buds. So, the first thing here will be bulbil. Fine. So, these bulbils are modification of axillary bud. And this modification is for two purposes. The purpose is storage of food plus vegetative propagation. Fine. So, what happens here? If I draw, this is the stem, and here there will be many leaves present like this in case of plant. In case of the plant, that is agave. And Dioscorea. These plants are having xerophytic habitat. Fine. So what happens here? One of these bud will grow into size like this. And when it grows in size, there will be storage of food, plus when it grows to a specific size, from there only development of new plantlet will take place. Fine. This kind of modification is for vegetative propagation. You can also call, in terms of biology, viviparity. Viviparity is a phenomena in which the seed will grow into a plant when it is there inside the mother plant. Fine. तो वो mother plant में ही जो seed होता है वो develop हो जाता है. That kind of phenomena is known as viviparity, and this you are going to study in chapter standard 12. And this modification of bud is bulbil. And this bulbil you will see in plant of agave and Dioscorea, And this is for two purposes, for the storage of food and for the vegetative propagation. Now, the second one is thorns. Fine? These are hard, spiny structure. Okay? Again, this is the modification of axillary bud. And it is having two purposes. Number one is protection against grazing and for storing the water or controlling the transpiration. I can write it as controlling the transpiration. Fine. So for conserving water, because you will see such kind of plant in xerophytic habitat, so their protection is also required, and water should be conserved in the, and the transpiration should be controlled. So for that purpose, the axillary buds are modified into the thorns, and these are the spiny structures. It is like this. Suppose this is the stem and leaf is here. So it is, obviously it is axillary bud. So here you will find the pointed structure, and this is thorn. And this kind of structure you will see in case of bougainvillea and citrus plant. Okay. Now the third modification is tendriller bud. So in case of tendriller bud, here the leaf is there and the axillary bud becomes tendriller. Okay, this thread like structure is the tendril. So purpose of tendriller bud is for climbing. Okay, climbing the support. So tendriller is for mechanical support. So buds are modified for the three purpose. One is for storage food and vegetative propagation. For that you will find bulbil. For controlling the transpiration or reducing the transpiration, you can also write here as controlling or reducing the transpiration, and protection against grazing, the axillary bud modifies into thorns. Okay, and you will find this structure in case of bougainvillea and citrus. Here tendriller buds are the axillary buds. Here the axillary bud will become thread like tendriller, and this is for the purpose of climbing on the support. An example here will be cucurbita plant. Fine, you will find this kind of tendriller structure in cucurbita plant. So this is all about buds and its modification. In next lecture, I will proceed with the other topics of this chapter. Till then, keep learning, be safe, and take care. And please don't forget to see my other videos, comment on that. That will give an enthusiasm in me to make more and good videos. Thank you so much and goodbye.